When I first arrived, Hong Kong was a very grey city. Even central Hong Kong was basically low rise at that time. There was a mass exodus from China. The crowded buses and the crowded city streets, the only way to deal with this movement of masses of people was in fact an underground railway system.
In the 60s, 香港政府已经就兴建地下铁路进行了深入研究和广泛咨询，其后获得立法局通过，地下铁路于1975年正式动工。
Hong Kong had never seen an underground railway, that we built it in one of the most densely populated cities in the world. It meant, for example, we were putting down sheet piles.Only 18 inches away from shop fronts.
香港天气潮湿，使本地的花岗岩易分解成粗沙粒，增加了工程的难度。
But on occasions, telephoned me early in the morning to tell me they'd had to.Evacuate all the residents because the buildings had become unstable. They were built with footings instead of proper foundations.
係好惡劣嘅環境嚟，冇一個正式嘅入口入條隧道度嘅。咁我哋咪就係落去捐落去行條隧道去揾呢架車咯。
咁佢哋成日話喂蚊咯，
嗰啲蚊嚇驚你。
我哋嗰陣都冇過海㗎，行隧道過去㗎。在尖沙咀行过去金钟。
当时全球除了日本，只有香港建设大型地下铁路。在缺乏有关建筑经验的情况下，公司曾进行大规模的招聘，招揽海外的专业人才和本地精英。
I had some tunnel experience, and also have some background in railway in New Zealand.And I was 29 years old. There were only 200 MTR staff when I arrived in February of 1976.
你諗到地下鐵路已經係好興奮。你諗下兩分鐘一班車，而每一班車咧可以載3000嘅乘客。當時我哋係對地下鐵路完全一啲認識都冇。
許業雄正是第一批送去英國培訓的14名操作人員之一。培訓期為3个月，學習如何運作一套現代化的鐵路系統。
我想不到我真的有机会在这个伦敦揸着 Piccadilly Line 的列车上上落落伦敦。说真的，当时我真的很害怕。
经过4年的建造，第一阶段的地铁修正早期系统就是今天观塘线的其中一部分顺利完成。在正式通车之前，还开放车站，让公众率先体验这个崭新的铁路系统。
啲客咧就会未识用嗰个 system 咧，成日喺个 entry 机入唔闸咧，就喺个 exit 机嗰度行翻出闸，就问我哋：咦，我哋搭咗车噶啦，点解咁快出闸嘅？咁样。
地下铁路很快成为大众喜爱的交通工具。一年后，服务更延伸到香港岛。从此，过海来往港九两岸所需的时间，从以往的可能数小时，大幅缩短至4分钟，准时可靠。
因为毕竟呢，入嚟间公司都希望在事业上有一番发展啦。嗰时仲后生。咁入到嚟之後咧，唔覺唔覺遇到啲唔公平嘅嘢，咁因此就大家喺埋一齊，就想去反映，其實就咁嘅啫，不自覺地好似嚟咗個罷工裏邊。其實我哋好想話俾全世界聽咧，我哋其實唔係唔中意港鐵或者以前嘅地鐵啦嚇，我哋唔係唔中意佢，就只不過係唔想見到一啲唔公平嘅一啲部門嘅行政嘅啫。 罷工之後咧，其實管理層咧、啲高級經理啊等等，佢都落咗去車站咧，同啲員工直接嘅對話同埋溝通，去了解一下其實問題發生喺邊咧咁。我好高興咧，見到呢啲高級經理咧落到嚟傾嘅時候好有誠意，同埋完全冇怪責嘅意思。事實上我都有參與咗個罷工嘅，咁但喺四個月之後咧，我係被揀選咗去升職添。
一次劳资纠纷推动员工与管理层之间的长期合作关系，地铁孕育出正面的内部文化，并率先引入核心价值，就是优质至上、互敬互重及准时按职。之后每个阶层的地铁员工加倍同心协力工作，让公司日益壮大。地铁要面对的挑战一个又一个。当市民越来越依赖地铁作为主要的交通工具，他们对服务的要求也随之提高，不太接受地铁延误或者服务欠缺。公司勇于面对每一次挑战，从运作、事故应变直到维修体制，都不断提升效率。因此，地铁的服务比启用初期更可靠安全。2004年，地铁面临一次最严峻的考验。
當然，我當時係唔知道其實頭來，我知道係縱火，仲有膽氣嗰陣時咧，我就繼續逼個 PA 咧叫乘客開始向後走啦。我要顧住全車乘客嗰個安危啦。我一見到月台嗰個光咧，我開始有啲興奮啦。到啦，到啦，可以有救啦咁樣。
We have done enormous amounts of contingency training, right? So what you don't see overnight, sometimes we will have a train running, we will simulate a fire, we set off smoke bombs in it, we will have volunteers on that train, sometimes as many as 2,000.
这些年来，在每个车站、列车到基建上，港铁都在背后努力改善，提升乘客每一次旅程的体验。
在列车上面，我们做了超过1000个改动，令到它更加可靠。其实在1975年购买列车，现时仍然是提供一个良好的服务。
随着铁路的发展，旧社区注入了新动力，而铁路加物业的崭新商业运营模式促成新社区的兴建和发展。以物业项目收益再投资发展新的铁路网，不用依赖政府的补贴，港铁依然可以维持日常运营开支。
You saw this open area used for a depot, and the thought came, this is not a very good use of urban land.And that's where Telford Gardens came from.
在鐵路上蓋起物業咧，係比其他嘅一般嘅物業咧係昂貴嘅，因為咧我哋要預先預留嗰啲嘅地基工程啊喺下邊，所以我哋做之前咧一定要好小心嘅策劃。
There is a complementary, if you like, value creation arising from railway and property.That was the whole foundation on which MTR was founded, that MTR would operate on a commercially viable basis.
1997年，香港回归中国，而地铁当时却没有时间庆祝，公司正忙于机场快线和东涌线最后期的兴建工作。去应对一年之后落成的新机场客运需要，确保能够提供高效的铁路服务。
机场快线咧系有好多前所未有嘅新嘅设施，比如话喺市区办登记手续啦。但我哋唔好忘记咧，就算依家咁成功嘅八达通咧，都系机场铁路所产生出嚟嘅一个副产品嚟。
地铁邀请了本港五大公共交通运营商加入八达通的行列，极高的使用率让八达通成为全球最被广泛使用的非接触式智慧付费系统。
People loved the fact that it would work inside a handbag or inside your wallet, and they loved it being able to be used on all the transport modes.
2000年，在香港政府出售23%股权之后，地铁正式成为上市公司，招股时收到超过20倍超额认购。
Many of the big IPOs, a lot of the shares are placed to institutions. But in the case of the MTR IPO, we actually had over 500,000 shareholders when we started, which is an enormous amount of shareholders to have.
2007年，地铁再创另一个新的里程碑，与公营的九广铁路合并，成为港铁。
There was very active discussions, and it took a long time. From the start to end, it was 3 years and 10 months. We took advantage of the long time to plan it meticulously. Every step was planned for the day of the merger.
我哋明白咧，兩間公司嘅文化咧係有所唔同嘅，所以喺合併之前咧，我哋已經做咗唔少嘅功夫。我哋咧不斷同員工溝通嘅，並且舉行咗咧好多嘅文化整合工作坊，邀請兩間公司嘅同事咧喺埋一齊。他们傾下佢以往的工作啦，啊，將來嘅工作同埋佢哋嘅期望。
我哋喺一晚之間，喺短短幾個鐘頭裏邊，將17萬個印有兩間公司標誌嘅一啲項目咧，全部更換曬。
喺合併嘅時候，我哋請咗好多6尺高嘅高人嚟幫我哋換指示牌，因為佢哋唔使用梯啊嘛。
当第二朝6点钟打开门，乘客一入到嚟嘅时候，佢所见到嘅所有标志，包括我哋嘅导向系统啊，包括我哋嘅地图，同埋其他嘅资讯咧，都已经全部印晒我哋新嘅公司嘅标志啦。
睇到一个商业嘅机构去营运咧，系有佢嘅好处，系全世界嘅模式都证明系。咁所以我哋要保持呢个喺个 merger 度咧，呢个问题就会反复咁样被提出嚟。因為他哋唔想一車做大啊！佢哋話即係一個 railway company 做大曬，其實我哋仲有巴士係同佢 compete 噶嘛。
兩鐵嘅合併咧，就大大提升咗我哋現金流量同埋質素，即係咧佢比較穩定咗好多啊！咁樣咧就因為咁嘅原因咧，就增加咗我哋嘅即係成個資產負債表嘅持續性啊！
30多年的时间，港铁却已晋升成为全球铁路的翘楚之一。港铁的标志在深圳、北京、伦敦、墨尔本和斯德哥尔摩都看得到。而在香港，随着首个旅游项目完成，昂坪360缆车于2006年启用后，港铁现正忙于建造5条新铁路线，包括连接中国大陆高速的铁路网络高铁。与以往一样，暂时的不方便，却可以为香港带来持续的增长和发展。
即系由观塘至到石硖尾，时隔30年可以 develop 到全世界都有我哋嘅铁路咯。即系作为一个就嚟退休嘅同事咧，我会觉得系好光荣嘅一件事咯。
讲最终一句咧，就系无论铁路去到边度，吓都系会产生佢自己嘅价值。好多新市镇咧，就系因为有铁路到。而產生嘅，
我都同爸爸一樣，應該都做足一世嘅啦。講啦，係啦，已經決定咗啦。20歲人已經知道我嘅人生係一路喺地鐵度走噶啦。
每個同事都要做好自己嘅角色，而每個同事俾出嚟嘅意見咧，一定會令到港鐵更加精彩。
重要嘅嘢就係要面對而發生咗嘅嘢，而係令到大家係明白發生咁嘅事。我哋得到嘅係乜嘢嘅啟發，而令到我哋知道係有乜嘢係做得唔好嘅話咧，係一定係要解決嗰個問題咯。
我希望咧，5年後、10年後、20年後，我哋仍係一個以優質服務為本嘅企業。
We couldn't have been the economic and financial centre that we are without the MTR.
Railways is part of a community.The surface in a railway, the assets of a railway have to change with the community. We not only build railways to meet transportation needs, but also to meet the community's needs.